Welcome back to Ignite. I am Lightning, and I'm here with my friend, Taisha.
It's Tisha.
I forgot to put my phone on mute. I'm going to do that right now.
Great job.
Thank you. I'm a professional. Can you tell?
You know, you had one job.
I have multiple jobs.
As of now, one.
Just
and
one.
And you failed. Just saying. Just saying.
So Tisha and I have been best friends for like... 5 years? Is that wrong?
I don't know. I don't remember how I met you, so to be honest, I don't know.
We met through...
Who did we meet through?
Ruth or Lexi, because Lexi was my locker neighbor.
I want to say Lexi, because Ruth never talks to anyone.
True. But... I don't know. I remember. I think we're literally what happened was is you... We're hanging out with Lexi, and you guys came up walking to my lockers, and I don't even think we, like, just meant to be friends. It just kind of happened.
Because I'm kind of awesome. And
shut the fuck up.
Let's be friends, and I was like, no. And then you just kind of slid into my DMs.
Yeah, I'm sure that's how that went down.
Is that how it happened? Because I was awesome, and you were like, eh.
You're still an open leg bonfire.
Excuse me, I created that?
Mm. Yeah.
So you're the open leg bonfire. There's a lot of fire going down there.
Cootie.
That's why it's open leg.
Cootie queen.
Lint liquor.
So yeah, we're best friends.
You look like a possum. Love you.
Uh-huh. I bet you do.
Maybe.
Did my sister tell you why I'm getting a nose job?
No.
She compares me to the painter from Hercules.
You know, I've seen that meme. Very true. Very true.
She also thinks I look like Kevin from Up. The bird.
Oh, the bird. Actually, yeah. I can see the reason. Is this why you like birds?
No! Listen here. I like birds because mine are trained to dive at your head.
If it flies, it must die. I don't
flush
care
him! Lee, Ashley.
Actually, you.
I hope you all die in a fire.
Really?
Well, I hope it's a cold fire.
That's not a thing. Fires don't work that way.
They should.
They don't. Be educated.
But they should.
They don't.
But they should.
Should.
No one.
Nobody can hear us right now. It's just gonna be awkward silence of.
So all we were doing is whispering how incompetent Jay is.
Listen here.
Listen, Linda. Listen. I'm going to need you to back down.
You're at a 10. I need you at a -2.
Excuse me. Wait, did you watch that movie?
Yeah.
I love that movie.
Listen. There's just too much free time.
We love free time. I've watched that movie like 5 times, just so no one knows probably what movie we're referencing. Would you like to tell them?
Now, I was going to ask.
It's Booksmart.
I was going to ask.
Ask what?
If you had seen Tiger King yet.
No. What is it?
So, it's this documentary of these... private zoo owners, and they have...
Oh, you're talking about the people who steal the animals.
Carol Baskin.
Who's Carol Baskin?
Okay. So, there's Joe Exotic, who is a country singer, and he now owns a private zoo. He's in jail.
Apparently.
And his rival is like this big cat sanctuary, and the woman who runs its name is Carol Baskin, and she murdered her husband and put him in a meat grinder and fed him to her cats, her tigers, supposedly. But there's no way she didn't do it. I think Joe did a lot of things. They're both crazy. It's a good show. You have to watch it. Anyway.
So a meat grinder.
Yeah. And fed the body after she put it in the meat grinder to her tigers.
So did she, like, strip the skin and like the flesh off the bone. How do you put bone through a meat grinder? How is that even possible?
Very difficult. What it was one of those. It was one of those electric ones. So, like, they could throw a whole cow in there and it would grind it down.
Jesus Christ! Was it like ground beef ground?
Yeah.
Or like...
Yeah, ground beef ground.
Interesting. I wonder how an eyeball looks ground.
Probably bloody.
Bloody or, you know, ground beefy. We don't know.
Do you want to find out?
Thinking about it.
Okay. Well, why don't you tell them what you do for a living?
So, I don't know what I do for a living, to be honest, but currently I do a little bit of everything. So right now I do network marketing. Okay, so right now I do network marketing. And that pretty much just looks like me posting, storying. Yeah, that's about it. That's what I do.
You just advertise.
Yeah.
You're an advertisement,
so,
basically.
Pretty much the company pays me for advertising rather than paying a big chain to.
There you go. It's cheaper for them. Nicer for you.
Exactly. And I still get money, you know? Small people money. But I'm going to make big money soon.
Black card money.
Black card money. I need a black card.
Is that your goal in life, is just to own a black card?
That is my goal, to be able to own and afford a black card. I want to go into my old college and be like, I own you now. That's how I want to be thriving.
Be like, you see this piece of plastic? I own your ass now.
I own you. Bow down.
Kiss the pinky. Drop your weapon.
Drop the weapon. Fix everything. Yeah, I just want a black card so I can own my old school.
I love that you're that driven to fuck them over.
Exactly. This is how I feel. Truly.
I'm so proud of you.
I actually want to buy my current school as well because they suck as well. They lost my files 3 times.
I still don't know how that happened.
I don't know how they did that. Ooh. They made me feel so uncomfortable. Like, because me and my dad don't have, like, the same last name, like, I don't get why I need to have the same last name as my dad, you know, because my mom hates my dad, but that's fine. But anyways, they had me turn in a DNA test.
Seriously?
Yeah. They had me turn in a DNA test, even though my dad's been doing my loan for the past, you know, 4 years.
Right.
And they go, oh, we need proof that he's your dad. I'm like, who else would be willing to take out a loan for me?
This random stranger I met on the street.
This random stranger who claims to be my dad for all this time.
It's just like, yeah, I'll take out a loan.
Exactly, because somehow that's how it works.
You know, if we could find strangers to give us money, we wouldn't be in debt. Hey.
Sugar daddy is what I like to say, but you know. Oh my god.
Do you want a sugar daddy?
It depends how much sugar they bring in.
Not a lot.
Sugar daddy who don't want no sugar.
Yeah. So just like a cam girl.
Yeah.
Of the, I'll sell you my feet pics for like $150.
Yeah.
For one picture.
We love feet pics.
You no, I no no no. We I this household does not like feet at all.
I don't like feet, but it's fine.
They make me uncomfortable.
But if I can send them and get $100,000 off of it, I'm fine with that. You know?
I mean, yeah, I'd probably do it if I could get, like, quick money off of it.
That's the only reason you will be taking pictures of feet, or even taking the socks off the feet to look at feet.
Very true. Socks just need to stay on feet.
Exactly. I pay someone to do my feet because I don't like feet, so I pay someone to do it.
I pay someone so I don't have to look at them.
Exactly, you know? Logic.
I understand.
You know, everything's closed now, so...
Yes, everything is... closed, and everybody's so very sad, but at the same time, stay home.
Exactly. Everything's closed. We're all struggling out here. My hair is orange, my feet are closed, my nails are closed because they're ugly now. It's ugly.
Shit happens,
yo.
So, how long have we been in competition for Christmas?
There was never no competition.
There's a competition.
There was never.
Do you want to bet, bitch?
So, are you going to actually try to bring some type of A game this year? Oh my god.
What did you bring to the table, Missy?
You know, a whole thing of cocaine. whole thing. With some Kool-Aid packets.
That was pretty good. I'll give you that. That was pretty, pretty good.
Thank you. I get better every year.
I have an idea for Keith, though.
And a bingo dabber.
I have an idea for Keith, though. Bingo dabber. I want to get, like, a red brick.
Yeah.
You know, just plain brick. And I want to put, you know, those PlayStation gift cards?
Yeah.
I want to get him, like, an iTunes one, a PlayStation one, and just put them in the holes of the brick. But...
Well, how the hell are you going to put them in the holes of the brick?
You can bend them. Like, if I buy it online and print out the code, I can fold that paper up and put it in the holes of the brick.
Since when do bricks come with holes?
A red brick? They have holes. Not all of them, but some of them.
Why are you insisting that this brick's going to have holes?
You know what? If the brick doesn't have holes, I'll make its own goddamn holes, okay?
So how are you going to make these holes?
How about we just go with a cinder block, because them bitches got holes.
Sure, Jay.
Okay, we'll go with the cinder block.
Sure.
I want to put that in there. I want to put the cinder block in, like, I want to put it in a box and then do the zip ties. Maybe get some chains with a key. But to get the key, you got to do some crazy shit I haven't thought of yet. And then put that one in a box, that one in a box, and just go until my entire apartment's covered in boxes.
You know, we gotta get over the box phase. Everyone's doing boxes. Is already know we're doing some fuck shit with boxes.
You gave him a gram of cocaine.
You know, but it wasn't in a box, though. It was in a nice Christmas bag.
And you bought the boy Kool-Aid and a bingo daughter and put it in the sugar. I'm sorry, the cocaine. He couldn't even keep the sugar.
Yeah.
What kind of gift is that where you can't keep sugar?
Excuse me, I didn't want him to keep the sugar. I just wanted him to have some sour, flavorless-ass Kool-Aid. And that's what makes it great. And who puts powdered sugar in Kool-Aid?
I do.
You want to talk about it?
No.
I don't think that mixes well.
It doesn't. It makes, like, a paste. Tie-dye my hair. Pasty Kool-Aid. Don't look at me like that. Why you look so sad? Why you look so sad? So, for clarification, Miss Taisha over here.
Jerome.
Seems,
I need you to calm down.
Seems to think that she is the Christmas queen, when in fact, she is not. And that title belongs and has belonged to me since the beginning of time, since Jesus roamed the planet.
Jesus didn't even create him yet. He was like, I'm a hold off, so I don't think that ever existed. He's like, I'm gonna hold off on this one. I can't take this one right now.
I was looking when I was Christmas shopping. I was looking for a crown, like just like one of those princess crowns.
Yeah.
And I was gonna make it say like second place or some shit, and I was gonna give it to you for Christmas. Yeah. But then I was like, do I want my ass beat today? Because I'm like, there's like 22 people in the small ass house. There's a man we don't even know just sitting there scaring everybody because he was the first to walk into the house, and we're all like, who the fuck are you? I turn the corner. What's his name?
I know.
Okay. And I was just like, I thought I was going to jail because this random guy's walking in my house. I'm like, oh God, don't.
What did you do for jail?
Don't shut up. Don't talk to me. That's the real tea. But anyway, Tisha thinks she's the Christmas queen, and I don't know how to break it to her that she is not.
Jay only wished he was the Christmas queen.
I know I am.
You're not.
I am.
I don't know why I keep claiming something that you've never had. Ever.
I've always had it.
Ever.
So what are we basing this on? Like, how good of gifts we get? Like, how much money we spend? What are we
basing
this on?
Off the creativity of the gifts.
Just the creativity.
Creativity.
Everything else is out the window.
Out the window. Creativity.
Now, are we doing categories?
Okay, we're going to make a list.
Are we making a list?
We're making a list.
Okay, so let's start with the creativity.
We're doing creativity.
Actually, you know what? I have to give the creativity to Haley this year.
What did Haley do?
She got me a bag full of tote boxes that had, like, a bottle of ranch, a toothpaste, a necklace, diamond earrings, like, because I was having a bad Christmas. I was just, like, in a slump, not feeling Christmas last year. And she told her mom, and her mom literally went out to, like, Walmart or some shit, bought the entire fucking store, and I will never run out of ranch ever again because I got, like, two bottles of Massive Ass Ranch. I just thought it was so fucking clever of the, hey, I'm not wrapping everything individually, but I will go to Dollar Tree and get you some clear ass tote. I still have the fucking totes.
Totes?
Yeah, they're like clear bins.
When you said totes, for some reason I thought about clear Christmas boxes or gift boxes. I don't know.
No, no, they were just like the plastic bins you get from the dollar store. But they like put everything in there, tissue paper and all. Who won? Oh, Keith did the Christmas pickle gift.
Because I wasn't here.
Yes, you were, number one.
No, when he found the Christmas pickle. Oh, you weren't. Wasn't here. I was running late.
Oh, you're right. Oh, by the way, I still have your box with the duct tape.
Of course you do.
You want to tell them what happened with that box?
No.
So each year I do a Christmas pickle gift. If you find the Christmas pickle, you get the extra gift. Gave it to Tisha, and this is where, like, the cocaine thing came from, is I bought these, like, they're boxes of candy from the dollar store, just a box, like a long rectangular box. Wrapped it, I put them all together, wrapped it in white tissue paper, and I put a strip of duct tape around it. I didn't know Tisha was going to find it and win, so when she did, she pulled it out, she's like, is this a fucking gram of coke? I'm like, yeah. It was M&M's, but yeah, it was a gram of coke at the time.
You know, it was very convincing.
But I also had duct taped the box shut, and she hated that. So I was like, you know what, just for saying that, I'm going to keep this box for you for next year. And sure as shit, I kept that box for a whole fucking year to give it back to you, and I still have it, and it's going to happen every year from now on.
Yep, so every present I got has been
in that box.
In that box.
Yep, and it's going to happen again.
I'm going to find something for you. It's going to be great.
Yeah, like what?
I don't know what it is yet, but it's going to be great.
You know what I want?
I don't care what you
want. A fucking house. If you find me a house, you will be the Christmas queen for all eternity. I will bow. I'm not cleaning your house because I'm tired of cleaning, and I will never do it again, you know, for a job.
Okay, but if you could get me a size red.
In Porsche?
In or Wrangler.
Wrangler. I thought it was Ram.
No, Wrangler. You could get me that too. But
what color do you want, Ram?
Size black.
Black. Yeah. Oh, I'm sorry, size. Size black, okay. Yeah. If you get me a size gray Avalanche.
I don't speak size.
Beat your ass.
I only speak gram now.
But anyway, that's the runner-up, Christmas queen.
Oh, me? Thank you. Thank you. I'll accept my crown during Christmas.
Runner-up.
No.
You have a lot of animals.
Yeah.
What do you have?
Why do you want to know? I'm just kidding. You already know.
I'm being nosy.
But so I have four dogs. I have a mix. We don't know what she is. We think she's part, you know, dinosaur. Pretty much indestructible. She's eaten a grape, a whole ass loaf of brownie out of the trash can. She's still here, so.
Ate a rat.
Oh, no, I said the grapes. I said the grapes. She ate that. Oh, she ate onions. Her favorite decadence is geese shit. Loves it. Loves it. My deodorant. She dabbles a little bit.
She ate your Deltorant?
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
She's still alive. I don't know how she's still kicking, yo. We don't
know. I mean, let her do her, whatever she want to do.
We're just going to look around 20 years from now and say, she's still here.
She's still here. How did she outlive me? The fuck?
Bring the meat grinder.
Carol Baskin.
Comes out whole ass dog.
Killed her husband, whacked him. Can convince me it didn't happen. Fed him to tigers, they snacking. What's happening?
What's up?
Carol Baskin.
But anyways, the other three we have two Shih Tzu poodles, and we have one mini Australian Shepherd who's always up to some shady shit.
You have the cutest. She's so small.
She's so shady.
But she's so small.
So shady. All I do is, like, when she does some shit, she runs her little ass under the couch, and all you see is a white snout and a red nose.
But she's so cute.
So fucking shady.
But Robin.
Also very shady.
But she's so cute. Why are all your animals so shady?
All the cute ones are shady.
Maybe that's just your parenting.
But no.
Making your children shady.
No. Okay, so, Farrah, backstory. So, a few months ago, we had went downstairs to go and, like, get our clothes out of the laundry area. And we come back. So, we had ice cream on the table. And you could probably already guess where this is going to lead. But we come back, and we're about to open the door, and we just hear, like, a clinking sound. And we're like, what the hell is that? And we open the door to Farrah halfway on the fucking coffee table, bending over from the couch, on the ledge of the couch, licking all of Martin's ice cream out of the fucking bowl. We looked at her, she looked at us, jumped down, and slid right under the fucking couch.
What a little shit. This was Farrah?
Yeah, this was Farrah. So the mini Aussie.
Farrah.
Yep. Her name is Farrah. It's actually after the god Hera and then Pharaoh. So we just wanted her to sound exquisite.
She sounds expensive.
Yeah.
We love an expensive hoe.
We love expensive queens.
We do. We're not them, but we want to be.
And Robin's shady because she likes to steal toys and hide them.
I mean, I think all dogs do that. No. Like, Zero will hide his shit from Erba, but Erba's also a cunt, so.
You don't understand.
Oh?
She's a hoarder.
Oh.
She puts it in places you know you ain't gonna get it. Like, so
like
under
where?
Under the bed, in her crate, or she'll just hide them, like, under the dog beds. She gets creative.
So she doesn't want that shit found.
She doesn't want that shit found. And she thinks she can, like, she tries burying things. Like, I'll give her a calming treat, and she'll, like, take it, put it on the dog bed, and try, like, burying it with her nose, even though there's no dirt.
What a little asshole.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
She sounds like a shithead.
Yeah.
You should sue.
Well, I'll just be suing myself because she has no money.
That's unfortunate.
They need money.
Do they?
Yeah.
Do they have bank accounts?
They should.
Do the receipts be looking like phone numbers?
No, not yet.
Not yet. Oh, so it's a goal.
Mm-hmm.
I love that for you. Why you look so sad? Why do you look so sad?
I don't like that.
Why do you look weird?
It's my face.
That's just how my face is. Why do you have to yell at me about it? Why is YouTube so explosive right now on my phone? I don't understand.
Everyone's trying to make their come ups with the quarantine.
True.
Everybody's trying to make it blow up.
What have you been doing for quarantine? Like, how's it been going?
I don't remember anything. But I remember.
We're just going to all block out this whole year. Like, 2020 didn't happen.
No, 2020 is going to happen. This is the year poor people thrive. Okay?
I mean, right now we are.
This is our year.
This is for the poor people, my poverty people.
The poor people all the way in the back row.
Remember that shit about the poors? The poverty people?
The poverty people. We're here.
There's just a write outside. Be like, yes, this is us. Poverty stricken people.
Now you all feel us. How does it feel to be poor?
How does it feel to rely on the government? It sucks.
It sucks. We do it all the time.
That shit sucks.
Mm-hmm.
And like when I do unemployment, I let people know, I'm like, that shit's gonna suck. Because it's not fun. Just getting through it is such a pain. Like, getting through it to get your first payment is such a pain in the ass. Like, they didn't pay me for a week because I was told I didn't have to go to a meeting. And then they turned around and said, no, you had to go. And I'm like, okay, well, I was told not to. And they're like, well, we're not paying you for it. I'm like, the fuck? Yes, you are.
I was like, so what type of stupid are you?
What breed of stupid happened to you?
So, are you stupid, stupid, mega stupid, or stupid?
Where'd you get your credentials? University of Stupid?
El Retardo.
El Retardo.
El Retardo, El Guaco. Free Shavacadoo.
Free Shavacadoo!
Continue.
Free Shavacadoo.
No one asked.
I want some free Shavacadoo. Shavacadoo is expensive.
Since when is Shavacadoo expensive?
What are you looking at?
Yeah.
Bitch. What are you looking at?
Why are you looking at me?
Bitch.
You look like your bird. All I saw was eyeball.
You look like a burnt Rice Krispie.
Thank you.
You're welcome. You're just not that salty.
I'm sweet.
I'm going to have to teach you how to be salty.
You're going to teach me how to be salty?
Mm.
No, thank you. Salt doesn't have much class. It dries the mouth.
Don't drink Dasani water.
Dasani.
Did you hear that?
Dasani is up the devil.
Did you hear about Dasani?
No.
Oh my god. Shane Dawson did a conspiracy theory on it. So the ingredients in Dasani water, two of them are drying agents. Tap water. And the other one is a chemical they use for lethal injection on death row.
Interesting. Is that why when you try to open a bottle, the sides crinkle?
Yep. And it fizzes, like, yeah. Pop? Yeah, that's why.
Jesus.
And I'm like, Jesus. Like, I went to Meijer the other day, and all bottled water is out, but Dasani hasn't been fucking touched.
Like, Dasani is here to stay.
And I didn't know Coca-Cola made Dasani.
That sounds about right, because Coca-Cola used to have Coke in it.
True crack.
Yeah.
So, we need to have paperwork to get into for our dear Morgan. Have you gotten anything from her? Like, ordered anything?
No.
She what did she make us? She made us coffee mugs with our like Steve's Horde logo from World of Warcraft and my lightning symbol.
That's cool.
She made us a bunch of car stickers too. Like I have a car sticker around my car. She makes baby clothes. She makes crop tops. The name of her company is Bookish Girl Crochet. It has high quality handmade things with the customer in mind, fully capable to adjust to the customer's wants and needs, as well as providing excellent customer service. Everything is made according to size, shape, and color, and wants of whatever the customer has in mind. They make dream catchers, crop tops, beanies, and tumblers. I got the tumblers. I think she made Keith a beanie.
Does she make blankets?
Yeah, she could if you ask her. It might take a while. She made Ashley a baby Yoda little thing.
Oh my goodness, I need that.
She makes really cute shit. I gave them the wrong promo code last time because Morgan was texting me she has a coupon code. And she sent me 100FF. I didn't know that the second zero was an O, so it's 10 off is her coupon code, not 100FF. Which makes so much more sense for it to be 10 off. So go to her Etsy store for Bookish Girl Crochet and use 10 off for 10% off your order.
We love a deal.
We do. I really want her to make me, like, a dream catcher, because I think that'd be really cute, especially from, like, crocheted material.
Yeah, I heard, like, with dream catchers, you're supposed to let someone gift it to you and not buy it yourself.
Yeah, I want to get Carly's information, because I know she's got an Etsy store, too, and I want to promote her on here, too, because she makes the cutest little fucking bunnies.
She makes
Did you see
so
them?
Many cute things. She made this one, I think, like, it was, like, a head warmer,
mm-hmm.
and I loved it, and I wanted it, and I was like, I want a blanket made out of that. So cute. She uses the most, like, cutest material.
She does. When I figured out who was pregnant, I think my friend Brie was pregnant with her first.
Why is everyone getting pregnant?
Everybody's pregnant.
It's like, it's in the air. And I'm just like,
close your legs. Yeah, you know what's in the air? Their damn legs. Like, she made, like, this cute little bunny doll, but it was squishy enough to where the baby could, like, squeeze it. It was the cutest fucking thing I ever seen.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I want one now. I have a baby.
I'll give it to my dogs. She made Robin, Fair, Berlin, and Arya, this cute little blanket, and it goes into, like, their big Tempur-Pedic dog bed, and it has, like...
These dogs have better bedding than I do, and I'm a full-grown adult. Shut the fuck up, bitch.
You know, that sounds like a youth
problem. Listen.
It's called Treatoso.
It's called I Have Bills.
excuse me. What have you been buying these last few days?
We don't talk about it.
Were they bills?
Some of them.
Have you been buying your own bills? Yes.
I bought these microphones. I bought a ring light. Mm-hmm. I bought 4 video games. I bought new table chairs.
Mm-hmm.
I'm gonna buy a new apartment.
Mm-hmm.
Listen, I see your point. I see your point. That don't mean you gotta rub it in.
So you can't get a temperature.
I don't need a Tempur-Pedic bed.
Do you not? I feel like everyone needs
it. I had a memory foam and we hated it.
Memory foam wears very quickly. Memory foam isn't meant to last for more than 2-3 years time.
Okay, because we only had it for like 2 years and then we were like, our backs hurt.
Yeah, with therapeutic, Tempur-Pedic, Jesus Christ. But with Tempur-Pedic mattresses, they come with a warranty that if it goes down, I believe, 2 inches, they replace the entire bed.
Really?
Yeah, that's what we have for ours.
I like that deal.
Yeah, and it's a warranty for 20 years.
Really?
Mm-hmm. And ours have cooling gel in it, so.
See, he would need that because he sweats a lot at night. I get cold so fast.
But the thing is, you may want to get a mattress protector because let me tell you a little story.
Oh, God.
So when we got our Tempur-Pedic mattress, we were all the way back in California. And when this...
You keep going.
Oh, okay.
I'm adjusting you.
Thank you. But, so, when we got this Tempur-Pedic mattress, we took our dogs out to the park, you know, like good dog parents. We only had 2 at the time. And we took Berlin and Robin out to the park. And Berlin, like the camel she is, drunk a shit ton of water.
Happens.
Shit ton of water. And she peed like 6 times before leaving the park. So we get home, we just put them in the room, and then I think we went out to, like, go and get, like, dinner or something.
Mm-hmm.
We come back. And we're just thinking everything's fine and dandy. And I lay on the bed. And I'm drenched.
In what?
In piss.
Ew, what the fuck?
She paid a puddle on a brand new Tempur-Pedic bed that we forgot to get a warranty on. Yeah.
I would have killed her.
Martin cussed her out in 3 different languages, legitimately. I think he cussed her out in English, Armenian, and Russian.
I probably would have snapped the bitch's neck, because I went zero. He's an asshole. If we don't, if we ignore him, he'll jump on the bed and just pee in front of all of us. I damn near kill him when he does it. I can't imagine what I would do, especially if it was a brand new mattress, but I'm like, you're going to die tonight. You're going to die tonight.
Hella expensive. And you have $2,500.
Bitch would have been dead.
We, imbibing Tempur-Pedic, it absorbs very well at wrong moments.
Like our issue with Airba. She, because we had the memory foam.
Yeah.
And that shit soaked in. And it's like, oh, memory foam never forgets. And I was like, this is utterly disgusting.
So much baking soda, cleaning sprays, awesome sponges, scrubbers.
How long did it take you to get that shit out?
Like 4 hours.
Jesus.
4 hours.
And what have we learned?
Get a mattress protector.
Get a warranty.
That as well. The mattress protector was expensive, but it's waterproof.
Where did you guys get yours?
We got it from Bed Bath & Beyond.
I need to go to Bed Bath & Beyond. I want a nice comforter, but I buy comforters all the time. This is the longest we've had this one. And I want to go to Bed Bath & Beyond because I heard they have really good ones. I don't want to get one until Erba dies because I'm tired of her peeing on all my shit.
Yeah, it's an investment for sure. Like, I think our mattress protector was like $99. Ouch. Compared to the $2,500 we spent, I'd rather do that and make sure it never happens again.
See, I bought my mattress protector from the dollar store once, and it sounded like it was fine and it worked. Like, it worked great. It just, whenever you sat down, it felt like you were sitting on a pile of garbage bags.
Yeah.
But it was comfortable. It was just loud. But again, it was just like cheap plastic that had stretch, like elastic in it. That's all it was. And I'm like, I could have made that from Joann's for $2.
You know, you gotta do what you gotta do. It's like my body's trying to burp, but I don't burp.
Like Tisha, you don't fart, you toot.
I toot my own horn. I blow my own trumpet.
Do you?
I do.
You're nasty. I have to sneeze. Miss Rona. Miss Rona.
What?
Miss Rona.
Miss Rona?
Miss Rona.
Miss Rona.
She was not invited to 2020. Mm-mm. Who invited her?
The government.
God damn it. We need to rally.
My conspiracy.
I'm just kidding. Don't do that. Please don't do that.
My conspiracy theory is. So, call me wrong. I don't care. But, so, apparently, it arrived here in February. On the West Coast, all the way somewhere in Washington, I believe, right? Yeah, Washington State. How the fuck did it manage to spread so quickly with, like, in, like, less than half a month?
Yeah.
There's no fucking way that it spread through 50 states that fucking quickly.
Because now every state has cases.
Exactly. From one person having it, there's no fucking way. So I have a theory that it's been here longer and they're just not telling us. And
it's How long do you think it's been here? Because I got really sick and a lot of my family got really sick in, like, January, and they were showing a lot of symptoms of it.
Yeah, I feel like it's been here for a few years, to be honest.
Really?
I honestly do, because a lot of the cases have been misdiagnosed as pneumonia or the flu. So, or, like, flu with, like, bronchitis or something like that. So, a few years ago, I would say, like, 2-3 years ago, I got sick, and they told me it was another strain of the flu, and they didn't have a vaccine for it. And then, like, I don't know if they ever made a vaccine for it, but I'm pretty sure that I had corona, like, a few years back. So there's no way that it all of a sudden just got here and spread that quickly. There's no fucking way.
No, because that spread very fast. Like, we're only on, like, what, month 2 of quarantine. And we're about to be on month 3 of quarantine. And before that, it was only here for, like, I think they announced it in, like, a month. Like, the coronavirus had just come to the United States.
Like, a month or half a month.
And it took off. And now there's, like you know, the Michigan is, like, the third highest state with it. I believe it's New York, New Jersey, Michigan. How the fuck is it spreading that goddamn fast? Like, are people really not, are they just being gross? Like, what's going on?
Like, because, like, another thing is, like, America's taking all these, like, safety precautions and, like, disinfecting everything now, but that could have also led to the cause of how it spread.
Right.
And somehow did spread this quickly. Because Americans don't disinfect and clean things unless they're mandated by law to do
so. No, we're fucking gross people.
Exactly. We're gross. Like, humans in general are gross. Cats are cleaner than humans.
Yeah. Well, not my cat. She's got issues, but...
You know, we don't talk about that.
Normal cats. Normal cats are cleaner than humans, yes.
Yeah.
We don't talk about buh.
Buh.
Buh. No, it's just it spread way too fucking fast, and I really do think the media is hyping it up to be a lot more than it is. Don't get me wrong, it's dangerous and it's killing people.
Exactly.
I really don't think it's as dangerous as the media is saying it is.
Yeah,
but time to inject that Clorox, just don't do it.
But exactly, like, it's just spreading way too fast for, like, as they say. Like, for example, like, why did we choose now to quarantine? And also, just throwing that in there, isn't it kind of coincidental that it happened same year as elections?
Yeah. Oh, no, everybody's thinking that. Everybody's thinking
exactly,
that.
Exactly. Every time during elections, some shit pops off.
Because now he wants to postpone elections.
Exactly.
Because of the virus.
Or do online so he can rig it again.
Yep. And yes, he rigged it. Don't try to say no. He didn't. Yes, he did. Shut
he
the fuck up.
It,
you can't tell me other. You can't tell me nothing.
Hillary was way ahead of him.
And then all of a sudden, see what my thing is I don't pay attention to politics, but I found this just fucking weird. She was way ahead of him, and then as soon as he was falling behind to the point where he had to drop, all of a sudden these emails pop up, and I'm like, where the fuck did these come from? They're like years and years and years old. I'm like, why does this shit matter now?
Like the past is the past. We're talking about the present.
And how, number one, how the fuck did you get them that quick?
Like, how did
you think he was just
playing?
You're telling me that the government couldn't find those fucking emails, but then he got all pissed off and played detective and found them? No.
Within like a few hours.
Yeah, no, I don't think he's that fucking smart. Obviously, he's not that fucking smart. He just told people to inject disinfectant into their fucking body. So no.
His whole fucking body is orange.
Truly.
And his eyes are white.
Yeah,
someone
why?
Explain.
His hair's fake.
His hands fake.
The most funny thing I think is like he has such a problem with immigration, but isn't his wife a fucking immigrant?
All of them were actually.
Then why the fuck is he having issues?
Exactly.
Yeah. Yeah.
Exactly. But my thing is, why do we call them Native Americans when it wasn't America to start with? They're not.
They were native
to
the Americas.
Because they're not. They weren't native to the Americas because it was never called America. They're native to whatever was called before.
Yeah. But I don't think they asked questions. They were just kind of, hi, this is our shit now.
Pretty much. Because I was like, you can't call them Native. I don't want to call them Native Americans because they're not. Cause
what would you prefer to call them?
I would like to call them Natives.
Yeah, I've heard that before. Like, just Natives.
Yeah, just Natives because they're not native to America. I'm not really sure what it was called before. Like beforehand.
I don't think we know because back then they had just not Pangea.
I don't think they named it.
Yeah, say they were just tribes back then.
I would just call them natives to the land or anything like that.
Yeah. Yeah, no, I probably would just call them natives too, because like you said, they weren't native to
a land that wasn't established.
Right.
If it was America and they settled here, like we came and settled here, he didn't discover shit.
Yeah.
He stole it.
He didn't discover shit. Like, that shit Ben knew.
Exactly.
And you're just like, hi, this is mine now. Tee-hee.
And how, you know, America was built on the backs of everyone else.
America is just some shady shit.
Exactly.
Everybody fucking here is shady. The fucking government is shady as shit.
Shady.
Fucking garbage people. Thinking they're hot shit.
Hot shit.
Hot damn.
Hot diggity damn.
Called the police and the fire.
But you know, before, you know, the FBI shows up, what's the next subject?
We got 20 questions, boo.
Let's do 20 questions.
You want to play around 20 questions?
Yeah, I have no questions, but hit me with a question.
Alright, so we're going to play 20 questions. What is... What's your most embarrassing moment? I'm going to kill my sister. She said, my life.
Let's see.
When I popped out the vajaj.
I don't know if I have any embarrassing
moments. Oh my god, you proud fool.
No, I say that because I'm so proud of everything I've done, even if they were retarded. Shit. I don't know.
Well,
okay,
the Fifi story is kind of embarrassing.
That's not embarrassing. I was just drunk.
Tell them what happened, because that's on the list as the Fifi story, so we can knock out two birds with one stone. What the fuck happened with Fifi?
Okay, I don't... Shit, I have a
you,
lot
It was
of...
Vicodin.
Was it Vicodin?
Yeah.
So I don't handle drugs, well, any type of drugs. I don't do drugs, as of now. But
as of this time, this moment,
this
I stopped.
Time. But so I took Vicodin from the doctor. I think I had, like, messed up my, like, ankle or something, or torn a ligament in my leg, which they misdiagnosed as my Achilles, just putting that out there.
Ouch.
Yeah, because how close it was. It's But yeah, so they gave me medicine for it, but it was more so to knock me out because they couldn't really do anything for the pain I was experiencing in my ankle. So I went and took a Vicodin, the lowest dose of a Vicodin. I don't even do well with codeine medicine.
Right.
So I took this Vicodin, and I went to sleep because I was starting to feel, like, very gross, and I felt like I had to vomit, so I went to sleep. And then I woke up, and my mom kind of, like, came in there for a little bit, I guess, from what she told me. And I just remember seeing a translucent, like, field of daisies. And I turned to ask my mom, "Where's Fifi?" And my mom goes, "Who's Fifi?" And I was like, "My dog. Where's my dog, Fifi?" And my mom goes, "Honey, you don't have a dog, nor is the dog's name Fifi." And now it's some type of running joke between all my friends about who Fifi is and where did she come from.
Because every time, like, number one, it's so fucking random. Why the name Fifi? What kind of dog was Fifi?
I was thinking maybe like a terrier or something.
I want to get a St. Bernard and name that motherfucker Fifi.
But, no, my mom used to have a cat named Fifi. And I guess oh. It was just in, like, my subconscious mind about thinking about Fifi. Are you taking a picture of me?
Maybe.
No soliciting.
Listen, we're promoting in this bitch, trying to get some questions. I already have, like, four, but I feel like me and you are going to pop through the four because they're so fucking simple questions. I've already read them. Teehee. Goddamn. Shut the fuck up.
Okay. Stop bullying her.
I always do, though.
She doesn't like it.
The only reason she... Why do you look so sad? The only reason she comes over here is to play Overwatch.
That's not true,
you know, she ate my candy.
She's a proper user.
So yeah, if somebody asks you your most embarrassing moment, I'd probably just go with the Fifi. You also rode in the back of a trunk.
I have a lot of long stories and we're just going to leave it at that.
Yeah, okay. That'll be for like when she comes on the next time, if it happens again. Anyway, also really quick, if you guys like any kind of guests that I have on here, make sure to let me know so I can bring them back. So far we've had Steve, Ashley, and Tisha. And then of course me, and I'm not going anywhere, so you're stuck with me. And I just licked the pop thing and it tasted like China.
How do you taste China?
You know when you walk in a dollar store and you go, smells like China. You know sometimes where you can taste that smell?
No.
It's not a pleasant taste.
No.
You've never tasted that smell?
I never tasted that smell.
You've never tasted that smell.
That's not... You can't taste a smell.
Yes, you can.
No, you can't.
Yes, you can.
You can't.
I didn't want to know that information.
Yeah. Last night, but anyways.
Your turn. Question.
What are the worst top three hair colors you've dyed your hair?
Orange.
Slim Shady.
Slim Shady. Burgundy and lime green.
You did lime green?
Mm-hmm. It was when my hair color faded from the blue. Because when I did my blue hair recently, it was green hair dye and blue hair dye because I ran out of blue. So I used green. That shit faded to a lime green and it was not my favorite. Those are stale. I bought them like a month ago.
Yeah, you didn't close
them. Yeah, they're stale. Or not. Never mind. Okay.
She's thriving.
She's thriving. She is. So yeah. So probably be my like worst three favorite like three least favorite hair colors.
The orange was a time.
The orange was a fucking time.
Yeah.
It was Dustin. What's your favorite movie?
As of now or all time?
All time.
A Long Kiss Goodnight.
What one?
Huh?
Excuse me. What one's that about?
So it's about, it's like this trained assassin who loses her memory, and then about, like, 6 years later, she's done had a kid and all that stuff, and then she starts to regain her memory back about, like, her being a trained assassin, and now she has a kid, and she doesn't know how to deal with, like, you know, emotions and shit, and then my boy Samuel Jackson comes in, like the bad motherfucker he is.
Your boy, Samuel Jackson.
So that's just, like, a shakedown about what the movie is.
Sounds interesting.
Yeah. Love the movie. It's like, I think it came out in like the 80s or 90s.
Oh, wow. So it's old. It's an older movie.
Yeah, it's an older movie.
Your turn.
Interesting.
They're from Aldi.
Yeah. Makes a lot of sense.
Trash my Aldi.
What question do I have for you? Why is your makeup so smoky?
I like the color black. So that's all I really use. I don't think I look good in any other makeup color but black and maybe a dark brown.
Have you tried purple?
I have. I wasn't against it. It has to be a dark purple, though, because light purples, I'll be like, ew, disgusting, throw her away.
Oh, light purple just looks like Barney, and we all know about Barney.
Fuck Barney.
Well,
that's why Demi Lovato's so fucked up.
You know, they're not wrong.
True. I just think it's because, again, I don't like any other color, and I just, I don't know, ever since I started doing makeup on myself, I've always liked the smoky eye looks with black. I always thought it made everybody look pretty, so I was like, I'm going to do that. And then, you know, I fail over and over it. I got something like, I'm just going to pile on black until my ugly goes away. And it doesn't go away.
We could work on it.
We could. I watched Nikki's tutorials and she was like using 8 different black eyeshadows. I'm like, I have one from Maybelline.
Maybe it's Maybelline.
Maybe she's born with it. Maybe it's Maybelline.
You sound like a goat.
Anyways. Easy, breezy, beautiful cover squirrel.
Easy, breezy, oh wait.
What color would you ever want to dye your hair besides the orange you have now?
It's not orange. Well, it's orange now, but it used to be pink.
Pink. Would you want to do any other colors?
Well, besides rose gold, because that's what I wanted to do intentionally. I really like teal.
Mhm.
I've been wanting to dye it teal, so yeah.
Teal's a fun color. It's a good club color.
Like teal mixed with like highlights, like lime green or like light green.
That'd be pretty.
Yeah.
That'd be really pretty.
I think it'll look cool.
Oh God.
I'd be like a glowing lantern.
Yeah.
Yeet.
A whole lantern.
Whole ass lantern.
A whole ass lantern.
Next question: how many tattoos do you have, and do you plan on getting more?
I have 11 right now, and I always plan on getting more. I wanted to get another one when taxes came. What the fuck did I have to buy? I had to buy something with taxes. I don't fucking know.
You know, taxes buys you.
What if taxes bought you? And then Corona happened, and now my tattoo artist is booked until 2021, so okay. Not anytime soon, but I do plan on getting more, yeah.
We love the tats.
Do you want any tattoos?
I do. So I've been talking about this tattoo for the longest damn time, and I want it, so... It's a thigh tattoo. It could be, like, the greatest thing ever, or I could regret it. But, you know, black don't crack. So, what I wanted as a tattoo, no one can tell me anything about this, but I wanted, you know the Ed Sheeran song, Shape of You?
Yeah.
So, on my thigh, I wanted the lyrics, we talk for hours and hours about the sweet and the sour and how your family is doing okay.
Mm-hmm.
And I wanted that in cursive on my leg with, like, a whiskey glass with, like, 2 ice cubes and, like, a lime.
That'd be cute. Edge.
I think that's super cute.
That is really cute.
And I want to be like a real fancy cursive writing, so when people are like, oh my god, that's so cute, what is that? And I'm like, it's Ed Sheeran lyrics.
It's Ed Sheeran lyrics, but you wouldn't have guessed that, bitch.
Because it looks so fancy.
It's like putting Miley Cyrus lyrics in like the most beautiful font. Be like, what is that? Like the theme song. It's Party in the USA.
It's the Hannah Montana theme song.
Best of both worlds, homegirl.
Pretty much.
Somebody got a fucking tattoo of Miley Cyrus's face on their body. And they got older and bigger, and he had his whole back covered in the Miley Cyrus face. So when he got older and it stretched out, now she looks like a Pablo Picasso painting.
We love Picasso.
We love Picasso. I wanted to cry because she's just, her nose looks like mine, and I'm sad. Because I'm like, oh God, that's so ugly.
She used to have such a cute nose.
She did.
What happened to it?
Cocaine went in there. We don't know what else she snorted. Probably that's probably how she takes Advil.
You know, some people take vitamins like that.
So they're special vitamins.
No, just vitamins.
I used to snort biotin.
Why?
Because I felt like it would work faster. It was when I was forced to shave my head, and I wanted my hair back. So I was like, oh, if I snort biotin, it'll come back faster. Because I'm stupid. It did not work. But now my hair is long as fuck, so I'm happy with it now. I just want it longer. You're just staring at me. You okay, Tisha?
It's very stupid. We could talk after this. I got a little something for you that you don't need to snort.
I don't need to snort it, but what if I want to snort it?
Just don't.
Okay.
Just don't. If you do snort it, you didn't get it from me. You don't know who I am.
I'll get arrested. Tisha did it. They'll be like, Tisha, who am I? Tisha Raw.
Don't know who that is.
Do we? Do we not know who Tisha Raw is? What's your next question?
Oh, it's my turn.
Yeah, I asked if you wanted tattoos.
Oh, yeet.
Yeet. That's just...
This is how his life works. Alright. So, what is the best memory that we've had together?
Oh, God.
I don't know if I should be scared or like...
I don't really know. My favorite memory... Not necessarily of us together, but just of you that made me laugh so fucking hard.
I do a lot of weird shit.
So. When I wrote about it in Lightning, it was... I laughed because I was remembering when you did it. It was the day after my graduation party. Wait. We were all fucking drunk and hungover. And we all sat in a circle. Like, we just pulled up these metal chairs and sat in a circle. It was the stupidest fucking thing you said, but I laughed so goddamn hard, which made my head hurt even more. We all sat in a circle, me and all my friends that stayed the night, and we were all going and we're like, hi, I like to drink. I have a lot of issues with drinking. Got the Tisha, she stands up and she's like, hi, I'm Tisha, I like weed. And we all just yell at her like, wrong meeting, and she's like, oh. And then you walk next door to my house, go inside, come to the bathroom, and you came back, you're like, all right, I like weed. I'm like, you're still in the wrong meeting, and you're like, I'm not moving again. I don't know why, but that memory always stuck, that you were like, wrong meeting, and like, I'm not moving again. So, like, this may be an Alcoholics Anonymous, but you can listen to my NA story, okay?
It went downhill real fucking quick. Someone stood up and was like, I like alcohol and crack. And we were like, wait. This is really the wrong meeting now.
I'm over here like, hi, I like alcohol, I get married too young, and I like cocaine.
Welcome to the new edition of AAA meetings.
Thank you. Oh, I thought that was directed at me right now. I'm like, oh. I'm like, well, I still like getting married. I like drinking. I just don't do crack no more.
You know.
Because crack on white does crack.
Who?
Joe Exotic, Tiger King. What? We've never really gotten into any fights.
Not yet.
5 years, still good. Who's your favorite friend?
As in...
Like, the friends that you have. You won't hurt my feelings.
Shut up.
Okay,
so that's very broad, because I do categories.
You do categories.
Yeah, I categorize.
Let's do the name some categories.
So I do, like, California friends, or I do, like, BFF.
Oh, yeah, this bitch jumps around a lot.
Yeah, I know people.
Yeah.
Or like my Canadian friends, or you know.
Your favorite Michigan friend.
I guess you, because like you're like almost my only friend that I talk to, so I guess it's you.
Well, people from Michigan are also fucking weird as shit, so I don't blame you.
It's a weird time, you know.
Michigan's a weird fucking place. Like, people want to come here all the time. I'm like, don't, it's a trap.
Like, Michigan has its beautiful parts.
It does.
It does have its.
We are not in them.
Well, I am.
You are. I am not. I am in the ghetto. You're on the fucking hilltops, okay?
We love the hills.
Yeah, we like it here in the slums.
Yeah, we don't visit the slums very often.
No, you don't.
That's where all the poverty people lie. I'm one of the
This dude got
people.
Shot across the street a couple of weeks ago because his toddler got a hold of his gun and shot him in the foot. I'm not even shitting you. That's where we live.
Great job, Jay.
Oh, because it's my fault.
Yeah, you picked it well. You just had to pick the one all the way up here, didn't you?
I didn't pick this one.
You didn't?
My mom picked this place. Mom found this place, and she's like, they look really nice.
So she fucked you?
She fucked me really good.
Right through the fucking ear.
Truly. Your turn.
So. Which Christmas party was your favorite Christmas party? Like, talking about event-wise, not about, like, gifting. But
no, yeah. Probably the first one that we had in my house, my apartment. Because it was, you know, before I moved out, it was we were stuck in this tiny room. Because we only had the party in my room at my dad's house. We were stuck in this tiny room. It got way too hot, way too messy. It was very cramped, and then I got the apartment, and we had this huge party at the apartment, and it was just great because, like, we were still in, like, a smaller area. It wasn't, like, a big house, but we had more room to walk around. Like, you could go to the bathroom without disturbing my grandma, or, you know, go get food without my dad going, "Did you take the last Twinkie?"
Well, I've been sitting up this high this whole time.
It has.
And I could have just...
I would say they move.
You know, it's fine. I've been sitting like that for, like, half an hour, so...
What's your favorite memory with... me?
So, funny enough, it's related back to, like, the, I think it was, like, the first Christmas party. So, it was, like, after everyone was asleep and we were, like, up all night talking about conspiracy theories and shit. And me and you legit stayed up from, like, 2 in the morning all the way until, like, 6 in the morning just talking about fucking life and, like, gassing each other up.
Yep. Be like, you can do it. You can fucking do it. Do you, boo?
Just do you, boo. You could accomplish anything.
You go to college. You go get the degree. I'll go get, you know, the pimp, the gangster street cred. You know, you go do you, and I'm going to make sure we got people on the other side that'll help us if we need it.
The crazy thing is, we weren't even drunk or high.
That's just how we were. And we still do that. Remember when you were in California, we would talk on the phone all night, just be like... Like, when you first started dating, we'd be like, oh my god, like, what's going on? I would call him and be like, what happened? Like, you gotta let me know. I know you went out on a date, ho. You gotta tell me what happened. Like, let me know.
When me and my ex-friend were, like, talking.
Oh, that ho.
The one who shouldn't be named properly. Mm. But, you know, I'm not bitter. Everyone gets what's coming.
Rhymes with stunt.
Cunt. But anyways, so this was when we're all keyed in together, all good together. And whatever I didn't fill in, she would fill in.
Yeah.
So yeah, it was a good time. I loved our chats. The chats were lit.
We had some good late night chats.
Especially when I roamed the streets of Hollywood like at midnight.
You're like, hey, so I'm just walking home. I'm like, where are you? Like, oh, like on, you know, Sunset Boulevard or some shit. And I'm like, oh, so you're gonna die tonight is what I'm hearing.
There were all the homeless people at Hollywood Boulevard, you know, the usual.
Just ready to die.
Where all the clubs are at. I think I was fine. All the clubs were there.
Yeah, right? I think you would have been fine.
Yeah.
Especially, like, with security and shit, if they had security.
Yeah, they had a lot of security, and, like, there were not as many homeless people roamed. Like, you had some crazy, like, drug people who were, like, out of it sometimes, but, like, there were a lot of security guards down there. It was very bright, so I don't think I would have been abducted, hopefully. A lot of malls and, like, bright lights and Scientology would probably be what I would have been kidnapped with, but,
We love a good kidnapping.
Yeah. Ooh, Scientology.
Oh, God, Scientology.
Fucking, I made a book about that.
Rest in peace, like, Leah. Leah Remini. Did you really?
Yeah. I'll send it to you to read.
Good. What's it on Wattpad?
No, I didn't put it on Wattpad. It was for a script writing class.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
What's your question?
What's your favorite type of clothing?
I'd say shirts.
Shirts?
Mm-hmm. Because, like, I have, you know me, my style's weird. I have shirts that sometimes are technically not clothing. I have shirts that are too much cover up. I have shirts that show my titties. I have shirts that make my titties fall out. I have shirts that keep my titties in. I have
the chicken cutlets,
my chicky nuggies. I like different styles of shirts. Like, there's this one I want that has an opening from the shoulder and, like, a zigzag all the way down. And all it is like, lace, but you can see the skin, but not too much. I just like shirts. I don't know why. Pants, whatever. I can wear sweatpants and a nice shirt and I'll still think I'm fly. You couldn't tell me nothing.
You pair of heels with the right shirt.
Everything's fine.
And some sweatpants.
Everything's fine.
Everything looks great. Everything's great. I did that for a party. I think I was coming back from one party heading to another one. So I had on my sweatpants, a pair of nice black heels, and just a cute crop top shirt. And I looked like $1 million. I created athleisure.
Did you?
I'm pretty sure I did, because that's all I wore in college. Mm-hmm. And then all of a sudden, like, everyone's like, oh my god, athleisure. I was like, bitch, I've been doing this.
True.
I look like I'm going to the gym and I'm not. I'm going to go and eat tacos.
Oh, tacos. How was your high school experience? Like, what did you, because I think me and you had two completely different high school experiences.
Yeah, like, I feel like everyone had, like, their ups and downs in high school, like, academically wise, like, I was struggling, but, you know, going through a lot of shit.
You're right.
Mentally, as everyone was.
Right.
But, like, when it came to, like, I would say extracurriculars or, like, cheerleading or band or anything like that, because I was in pretty much everything under the sun. I think I really thrived and excelled around that. I really did good with performing arts, so I think high school was a pretty positive experience for me, and I learned a lot from it. And to be honest, I would do it all over again, minus the academics.
Yeah.
I miss lunch and I miss detention. Loved it.
You miss detention?
I love detention.
Why?
They had to stop putting me in detention because I loved it so much, so that was my punishment, to not be in detention.
Why?
But I just showed up. Because I like talking to the people who were in there, even though you weren't supposed to talk. Like Mr. like Bailey or something.
Oh my god, Mr. Bailey. He couldn't tell you nothing.
No.
We love Mr. Bailey. He still works there.
Yeah, he does.
Why? What's his job?
Yeah. It's just if you take it personally, I thought it was funny.
Me and Carly used to sneak out because we didn't have a fourth hour.
Yeah.
So me and I would come back from teaching, and then Carly would be ready to just walk around the halls, and we would go smoke behind the fence, and Mr. Bailey would be like, can I come?
Carly used to smoke?
Yeah.
Really?
Me and her used to sneak behind the fence and smoke. Yes. And Mr. Bailey came with us once, and I was like, oh my god. He was like, can I come with you? I'm like, yeah, like, sure. Like, I thought he was kidding, but he followed us out, and I was, like, so scared. I was 18, and so was Carly, but I'm like, technically we're not on school property. We have a free hour. We're still technically in school. Like, I just felt weird smoking in front of a fucking teacher at school.
Well, technically, he wasn't a teacher. He was more like a...
Yeah, and I'm like, who was it? Deputy. When we graduated, he came out to have... He had a cigar, but we all had cigarettes. And he's smoking with us. And I was like, this feels fucking weird. You're a cop. And I know I'm, like, of age and shit. Now you have to be 21 to smoke cigarettes.
Stupid.
I know. Like, you can fight in war, but you can't have a fucking cigarette.
Or, like, a thing of beer. Come on. Like,
my God.
England is doing it right. Some of the times.
Some of the times. Not always.
Yeah, but when it comes to, like, alcohol and stuff, they're pretty lenient about it. Like,
yeah.
You start at 16, I think.
Right.
With, like, I guess, like, parent consent or whatever. But even with parent consent in the States, you can't. America's built on bullshittery. Don't get me wrong.
100%.
I love America, but, like, you know, bullshittery at its finest.
No, seriously. Like, 100%. Like, 100%. It's like that. Everything's bullshit.
Mm-hmm.
It's absolute crap.
Everything's hypocrisy.
We do have some questions, because we have gone over the hour mark again. So question number one comes from Anonymous. I really should be setting a timer, but there's a timer countdown right there. I just can't see it, because I'm blind.
It's called YouTube.
This one's an anonymous question. Have you and your friend ever gotten into an argument, or have you ever been annoyed by each other? You can answer that first.
Not really, but when he doesn't call and check up on me, like we usually do, I get a little bit annoyed. But other than that, nothing.
Say, no, not like, normally, everything's fine.
Yeah.
I don't really remember when I would get annoyed with you. I think the only times I've gotten annoyed with you is when you and Lexi were still friends, and you would defend her, and I was like, okay, listen, I understand, y'all been friends longer, she's sneaky. Not saying she's a bad person,
she's
just
not a bad person. It's
sneaky.
Just, I feel like everyone had their times, and especially in high school, thought they had to do different things to, like, fit in, I guess.
Right. And I mean, it shit happens like that, too, and
yeah.
I mean, like, that's why I'm, like, not... I have no ill feelings, it's just shit happens.
Yeah.
Let's see, get off this one. Oh, me and Ashley read that one. That one was... interesting. The one question that me and Ashley got was, why do kangaroos have three vaginas?
Do they?
They apparently, I don't know.
Really?
I don't know.
Wow.
If you could date any celebrity, who would it be?
I have a list.
I know.
I have a whole list. One of them is 57.
This isn't your podcast.
I don't know. I feel like...
You don't have a celebrity you would date?
You wanna
get... I feel like... No.
Oh god, who played Oh, I know his name. He's from American Horror Story.
I know who you're talking about.
Not him.
No, not him.
No. Fuck, what was Matt Bomer? Matt fucking Bomer.
The thing is, I'm terrible with names.
Oh, I'll have to let me Google a picture of him. He is okay, well then that works out perfect for me now, doesn't it?
You know, we could flip it and reverse it.
What the? We could flip it and reverse it. What's your favorite song? Is a question.
I know it was a question. Shut up. I have a lot of favorite songs. I would say just one or two.
Okay.
So one?
One.
I would say Thank You Next by Ariana Grande.
Thank You Next. That's Matt Bomer.
Ooh,
isn't he?
Good luck, I'll have to fuck him up, though. I would say Thank You Next because every time I listen to the song, it has a different meaning for me.
Mm-hmm.
So I would say, yeah, I can relate to it a lot.
I like that song. It's a good song.
It is.
I'd say, again, I mean, Ashley had this question last time, too, but apparently people like to know what our favorite songs are. Mine won't change. The End of the Dream by Evanescence from Synthesis. So it's not the rock version. It's the orchestral one. Because, you know, orchestral should be hitting different. It gets you in your feelings and shit.
Exactly.
You know, and all that fun shit of getting you in your feelings. What's your favorite dish? I like cups. Because you can
dish?
Hold them.
I thought you had food.
I did, but did you ever see that Demi Lovato interview? She was like so fed up with her shit. They were like, what's your favorite dish? She's like, I really like cups because they keep hot things out of your hand and you can hold them and yeah, they just look good. I'm like, you know what? People really thought she was serious. I'm like, no, she was over fucking interviews. Like, that's all that shit was.
I like cups.
What's your favorite dish, your food?
So my favorite dish would probably be like, we used to make carne asada bowls before I became a polyamorous? No, pescopolitarian.
She doesn't eat red meat.
I don't eat red meat, so I only eat poultry and fish and vegetables, of course. So my favorite dish would be the carne asada bowl
mm-hmm.
that we make at home because Chipotle just ain't doing it right since we started making it. But yeah, I like the carne asada bowls, but now I substitute the carne asada just with turkey.
Sounds good.
Yeah. I'll make it for you one night.
Do it. You made the best chicken noodle soup.
Thank you. I learned from my dad.
This is how good of a friend she is. What was I sick with? Oh my god, it was when we couldn't figure out what the fuck was going on in my stomach.
Oh, yeah.
I couldn't hold down water. I couldn't stand. I couldn't move. Every 2 seconds, I was running to the bathroom. It was fucking hell. Tisha, the sweetheart that she is, went grocery shopping. She bought me fruits and veggies. She made me a huge-ass thing of chicken noodle soup, and it was the best I've ever had.
I added flax seeds for digestion.
Oh, my God. It was so good. And it worked, because apparently, like, 3 days after I finished the soup, I was completely fine. Like, went to the emergency room and everything. They gave me a pill to stop cramping and spasms and my intestines from swelling. I took that the day after I started feeling better because I had your soup and I was like, whatever, I need that soup to digest. I'm not going to take this pill when I'm digesting soup because, you know, not any solid food in there really.
Yeah.
So I did that and then I felt better and I was like, wow, every time I'm sick, I have to call Tisha and be like, I need the recipe.
Yeah, the flaxseed is really good for digestion. We actually use it with our dogs as well for their digestion since we feed them raw food.
Right. What kind of car do you drive? I drive a Saturn View. What do you drive?
I drive nothing currently, but I'm working on having 3 cars.
That's her goal, to just have 3 cars.
And a motorcycle, because I'm cool like that.
If you could have a sugar daddy, would you?
Yes. Yes, I would. I need a sugar daddy. Who
would you seriously,
no
though?
Yeah.
Like, would he be okay with that? Because I know mine would kill me.
You know, we're not going to think about it.
If you were offered $500,000 to do porn once, would you do it?
Yeah.
Seriously?
I would. How much?
$500,000.
I honestly don't care. I'm very comfortable with my body.
You do porn.
You said once?
Once. If you were offered to do porn for $500,000, just one time, one video, like,
okay,
I would be afraid it would go, like, viral. Like, it probably wouldn't,
okay.
But I would be so scared
of
that.
So there's different types. There's the ones where you show the face, and then there's the ones you don't show the face.
Well, what would you do? No show face?
No show face.
But what if they made you?
It depends. Are they paying extra?
No, it's still $500,000. I'd have to say it would cost me, like, a good $1 million to do porn.
I would do it. You know, you gotta live once. Who actually cares about morals these days?
I do. Ooh, sometimes.
I have no. Sometimes. It depends what it is.
I mean, well, yeah, kind of. How many animals do you want? That's the last question.
How many do I want?
How many do you like? Like, for me, like, I want a cockatoo. I have my bird, but I want a cockatoo. I would love to have at least... I do. I would at least like to have one horse, one cow, and two huskies.
Girl,
that's pretty much all I can think of.
I want a chicken.
You do?
Yes, named Maurice.
Maurice or Orice?
Maurice. I want a miniature pig.
Oh, yes.
I don't know if I want a horse. I want a small horse.
Pony.
Yeah, a pony. I want a Frenchie, and I want a munchkin cat.
I have a munchkin cat.
They're so cute. I want a munchkin cat so freaking bad.
See, ours is mixed with Maine Coon,
which
is a very weird combination. So if you would have taken out the Maine Coon, she would have been so much smaller, and it would have been so fucking adorable. But since the Maine Coon is in her, she's got the short stubby legs, and then she's just got this massive fucking mane.
I want a munchkin cat, and I want to name him Link.
Link. I love Link.
Muncho Man.
Oh,
what was or King Louis?
The third.
No, just King Louis. He's the first now.
What would you call him, King or Louis?
Just King Louis.
King Louis.
Or Lou.
Come here, Lou. I had a dog named Lou. My grandma put him to a farm. Also, we talk about my grandma a lot.
Bring in the peanut butter.
True.
People mozzarella sticks with peanut oil.
Well, see the thing is, is like I called Ashley the other day when she was getting all political on the Facebook, and I was like, "Can we flush her?"
How do you flush a granny?
Ha! Google's how to flush grandma, and they're just like pour her ashes into the toilet and flush.
I was telling Martin about the one thing that you and Jeanette used to say a few years ago about Texas Crematorium, I think.
Welcome to Texas Crematorium, you kill and we grill. This is 8-Ball speaking. How may I direct your call?
Yeah. I told him that. He goes, why is that so true, though? That's all they do.
Did Jeanette tell you the pizzeria one?
I think, but I didn't remember it.
Tim's Abortion Clinic Pizzeria, your loss is our sauce. How may I help you? Detroit Children's Hospital, you beat them, we treat them. There's a lot of bad ones.
But we love them.
We love them.
We all love a sick joke every now and then, unless you're so very righteous.
Very true. Well, thank you for being on the podcast with me.
You're welcome. It was an honor for me to be here.
So you've never done it before either.
No, I haven't, so I don't know what I'm doing currently.
Well, now you have the experience to do it.
Yeah.
And these microphones are cheap as fuck. Like, I can send you the link. Do it, boo.
I don't know if I'll do the podcast.
No?
I don't know.
I'm doing okay. I mean, I'm not famous yet, but we're working on it.
We're working on it.
Steep slope.
Yeah, baby steps.
Baby steps. But anyway, guys, that's it for today's episode. Make sure you guys leave us a 5-star review and give us some comments. Also, leave some questions for the next podcast and let me know what friends I have on here that you enjoy having or would want to come back. Make sure you follow all my social media links down below. I will also link Tisha's YouTube channel called Life with Tisha in the description below as well. So make sure you check her out. And thank you guys for joining in. I'll see you next time.